Okay, with us on the debate, there really should be no issue on this one, but I don't know why some people call this forced nationalism. I don't know what is forced nationalism. I mean, if you're a national of one country, nothing that, at least of all the flag, would have to be forced on you. We support this. And with us tonight is Dr. Sambit Patra of the BJP, Mr. Venkatesh. He leans towards the BJP. That's a disclosure on top. General GD Bakshi, Mohandas Pai of Infosys, Sunil Alagh. Mohandas Pai, formerly of Infosys, now his own man, entrepreneur and an investor. Sunil Alagh, chairman of SK Advisors. Dr. Imankalyan Lahiri, professor of international relations at Jadavpur University, where there were clashes today between ABVP groups and certain Jadavpur University student groups. Saira Shah Halim, writer and activist, she's joining us from Kolkata. Shabnam Lone, Supreme Court advocate. And Dr. Ajay Alok of the JDU, we've got a big panel tonight. I want to start with the contrarian voices so that I try to understand what their reasoning is. In my view, there is no reasoning available here. Why would anyone have a problem, you know, with the national flag being unfurled proudly, as it should have been all this while, but in the given context, even more aggressively, all across, and especially at JNU? Mohandas Pai, why don't you start the debate?
Arnab, I am all for the national flag being on the top of every institution.
Yeah.
But I don't like a compulsion from the government that you must do it. That's the only thing. Because it must be left to citizens to demonstrate their affection. If somebody doesn't want to fly, it doesn't become a less of a patriot, less of a nationalist. And you must not bring in the distinction. I mean, we must fly. Like Americans, all of them fly. Nobody compels them to fly. It must come from within. Now, this HRD thing that on all universities, you must put it.
Not all, only central universities.
Central universities.
Which are affiliated to the government.
Yeah, tomorrow,
they receive significant amounts in government funding and subsidies.
Tomorrow it can come to everybody. But, you know.
No, if government.
Arnab. Making it compulsion. I'll tell you, Arnab.
What's the compulsion? The flag. No, Mohandas Pai. The flag, for me and for you, is a source of pride.
Absolutely.
It is a source of inspiration.
Absolutely.
So I would feel very proud if someone were to say, I have a 207-foot mast.
Absolutely.
And the flag on top of it. I don't know. What's...
Arnab, you remember the debate we had about the war memorial in Bangalore? Now, you please come to the war memorial and see how it is maintained. It is maintained in a shabby manner.
No, but...
Is it being disrespectful?
Hang on. That's a different argument.
For a flag, there's a protocol. There's a rule. You have to maintain as per the rule. You have to bring down the flag in the evening. You can't let it be in the dark.
Right.
And in the morning, you must raise it up.
So
you must follow the proper protocol.
Yeah, I'm sure it will.
And if they don't follow the protocol,
I'm sure they will. How do you presume
shabbily,
they won't?
Do it shabbily. We are going to get more hurt.
Let them go. Sunil Alagh.
If one, somebody does it shabbily, then I think he is genuinely disrespecting the flag. Why should he do it shabbily?
Why put this?
I mean, what is there? Look,
I'm for the flag.
One second. If Infosys is funding somebody and says, I want to fly the Infosys flag wherever I fund it.
But these are
one second. And therefore, can anybody object to it? They are not saying that if you are running a private institution and a private school that you have to fly it. They are saying anyone that the government funds and is dependent on the government should fly the flag. Now, I don't understand, why are you saying, no, I will not fly it?
Are we as a nation now going to be on the back foot vis-a-vis the pro-officer lobby? Let's get Dr. Lahiri in. Is Jadavpur a central university?
It's a state university.
It's a state university. If there was to be a large flag that was to be hoisted in Jadavpur University, would you have a problem? Would anyone have a problem?
See, we have a problem.
What would your problem be?
Problem
you would have a problem with the flag being hoisted.
Not with the flag, but with the policy.
The
policy of just flying the flag within the university campus. Because whether it's a central university or a state university, all the universities receives fund from the government, either for the central government or from the state.
I want to understand, what is your problem with the flag?
What is your objection with the flag? In the autonomy of the university.
The Indian flag is infiltrating the autonomy of the institution.
Good God.
The Indian flag is.
It is the autonomy.
The Indian flag. Sorry, but this is amazing. The Indian flag quietly standing there. One second. Just a minute. The Indian flag quietly standing there and fluttering in the air.
Nationalism is interfering in the functioning of the university. This is exactly the problem I have.
One second. Okay. GD Bakshi is coming on.
GD Bakshi.
Yeah. No, I just, let's have all the arguments tonight so we realize what the arguments are. Yeah.
Arnab, as a veteran soldier, I was amazed to learn that the national flag was not being flown on our universities. Are these independent enclaves under the United Nations? Are we supposed to sing the Communist International there? Are they not sovereign part of Indian territory? I see the point now, what these separatist supporters have achieved. They have put us so much on the back foot that you have to think whether a Pakistani flag should fly in JNU or an Indian flag. This is utterly disgraceful.
You say that this is ridiculous. I have one question.
Sovereignty of the republic fails to
hold. GD Bakshi, if I can come in, please. GD Bakshi.
Why was this flag not flying there?
GD Bakshi, I have, you know, I am amazed, viewers, with the logic that is being presented by these groups day after day after day. I am amazed that they have lost their sense of reason. They said having an Indian flag on the which is hoisted in a central university campus will interfere in the autonomy of these institutions. If central universities and institutions across the country can, if central universities and institutions across the country can celebrate Republic Day and Independence Day and wave the flag on those days, what is the harm in having a flag waving on the campus for the other 363 days? By the way, Jadavpur University is not a sovereign body, is it?
No.
Are you like the Vatican?
Not, absolutely not.
You're not a sovereign. You're part of India, right? So what's your problem?
These are the autonomous bodies formed under
autonomous,
the Act of Law.
Autonomous in your functioning as a...
We have our own flag.
You have your own flag.
Yeah, Jadavpur University is having its own flag.
So, Professor Lahiri, reveal yourself a little bit more. One second.
No,
he says he has his own flag.
Oh my God.
No, all the universities are having their own flag to fly.
It is subordinate to the Indian flag.
So that flag is an alternative to the Indian flag.
This is perverted nationalism that I'm forcing.
I'm really sorry.
That you fly
I'm really
flag.
Sorry.
What is your idea?
I don't know whether to laugh or to cry on this one. But this, as far as I'm concerned, this is not an example of forced nationalism because no one is forcing the Indian flag down your throat. No one is telling you to wear it on a daily basis. No one is even asking you to sing the national anthem or chant Vande Mataram. No one is forcing you like Sambit Patra did the other day to say Bharat Mata Ki Jai or express your pride in your nationalism. It is simply the problem appears to be the sight of the national flag is seen to be an insult to people. Are we so ashamed of our national flag?
No.
I am so glad this move has been.
Yesterday, the ABPP students. The students carrying the national flag has destroyed our canteen.
That's very different. What is that?
So what is the use of that?
Flag?
So
that is different.
What is the use of that? And secondly, I want to make another argument. You go for the Manipur University. You go for the other central university.
I don't know what to say now.
So if you...
Viewers, are you watching this?
Viewers... Nobody is asking you to sing the Bhagavad Gita in the morning.
No.
Nobody is asking you to say Vande Mataram.
You cannot force something upon an autonomous body.
Are you part of India or not?
No, I'll tell you one thing. Professor Lahiri.
I don't believe
this. We should not get upset with what Professor Lahiri has said. Professor Lahiri, your presence in the studios of Newshour this evening. And the nature of the argument that you are putting only reaffirms my constant suspicion over the course of the last 4 or 5 days that the pro-Afzal groups have no intellectual argument that is left. Now they are going into frivolities such as this flag is against us, we don't want the flag in our canteen, we have our own flag.
No.
Does your arts department have a separate flag?
No, our universities have
a flag. No, does your science department have a separate, maybe your economics department has a separate flag of its own? Why you need the Indian
flag?
What do you think of this argument tonight?
Oh boy.
This is the argument that is put out. And all the practitioners of their own warped definition of freedom of expression tonight. I believe in freedom of expression, which is why I allow Dr. Lahiri to make such comments in the course of the program. Sambit is responding, but it's a serious debate. Sambit, please. on the forced nationalism debate.
Mr. Lahiri, let me begin by saying I don't believe that I'm participating in a debate where there is a professor who says that he's pained because he has to hoist the national flag in his university campus. Let me begin by rhetoric. You are sitting on the right side of Arnab, but you are extremely wrong. You are absolutely wrong. Now let me bring out an emotional note. Whatever number of panelists we may be over here, Arnab, let me tell you, my wish, we are all mortals. We are all little small mortals. My wish, and I am sure everyone's wish in this panel is, the day we die, we should have served this nation in a way that our body is draped on the tricolor.
Yes.
That's the wish of every small kid of this country.
I just want to ask
one question to him.
If a small mortal like me and you want
now, have you read the book Nationalism by Tagore?
I ask you, a living university, throughout its life by a tricolor?
So what Tagore says, don't fly the Indian flag.
I don't have to read any book, sir.
Professor Lahiri, I tell you this. GD Bakshi. GD Bakshi, just one minute. What did you just say, Professor Lahiri? I've been indulgent of you all this while. What did you just say?
I said nationalism does not mean destruction.
Nationalism does not mean destruction.
Outrageous.
And as far as people like Professor Lahiri, and I am pretty sure that tomorrow there will be those half-baked edit page columnists, you know, semi-academics will say, this is freedom of expression. I would agree, this is freedom of expression. Which is why on the NewsHour I have to listen to ridiculous stuff like this. And I will still allow him his right to say it, but he should know that the Indian flag in its current shape and form was arrived after a consultative process with the formation of the Flag Committee in 1947, which was tasked with the job of finding a symbol that encapsulates all of India. If you talk about destruction, remember, the flag with all its colors and symbols is a representation and an encapsulation of all of India. How dare you say that this amounts to destruction? Why should there be any doubt over the intentions of anyone seeking to give greater presence to what our founding fathers devised and envisioned on the 23rd of June 1947? You claim you are an academic. You don't even know your facts. You have some silly half-baked research, and I've been indulgent of you so far. I've been indulgent of you so far. Ajay Alok, oh my.
What is that? Does not mean that.
This is your problem. I don't know with which prism you look at this.
Totally misguided.
Arnab,
Ajay Alok, please. Mr. Venkatesh, have you been listening to the debate so
first
far? Mr. Venkatesh, I see your hand raised up, but I'll see the other
first
side.
First of all,
Shabnam Lone, Ajay Alok have not spoken, neither has Saira Shah Halim from Kolkata tonight. But I'd like to start with Ajay Alok. Ajay.
Arnav, I guess that day was the moment of joy for every Indian when Naveen Jindal won this case in the Supreme Court that every Indian has a right to hoist the flag, the national flag, because earlier it was restricted only to very few people. So we got a right that we can have a national flag on every household. And that's our right, and Naveen Jindal got it for us. Good. On that very day, our leader Nitish Kumar has made a statement that it will be good that if every government offices, every government offices, forget only central university or state university, they should also host the national flag on a daily basis.
Yeah.
Very good. Today also it has been done.
No,
today
no,
also it has been done by the government.
After one so second. Many no, let, let him go.
And prolong. Then also, better late than never. We should welcome it.
Yeah.
But again, the question comes here, what is the timing for this? What is the timing? You have to look into that.
Can I tell
now
you the
you
timing?
You just mentioned 1948.
Can I tell you the timing?
Yeah, 1948.
No, I'll tell you the timing.
You mentioned
I one sentence on the timing.
No, listen to me.
Give me
10 seconds.
No, I'll give you more than 10 seconds. I'll have 5 seconds on the timing. The timing is when there are people who are trying to make Afzal Guru into some kind of a fashion statement. That's the timing. The presence of the Indian flag on the campus will serve as a reminder to people who seek to make universities in India dense of secessionist activities, that their actions will not be eventually tolerated. Please continue.
Completely agree.
Please, the timing is appropriate, I say.
And then
this is the right timing.
No. It completely agreed. And that's why it becomes more important. But right now you mentioned 1947, when this flag committee has finally approved that the tricolor will be the flag color. Now let me take you back to Mr. Sambit Patra, founder, fathers, Mr. Golwalkar book, bunch of thoughts. There is a column called Drifting and Drifting. In Drifting and Drifting, Mr. Golwalkar clearly ridiculed the tricolor and he said there is no point in having tricolor as a flag for India because the primary India means Hindutan and there should be a Bhagwa color. And that's the reason for 55 long years we haven't seen a Tiranga over RSS headquarters in Jhandewala or at Nagpur. Now today,
Ajay Alok, listen, I will suffer anything. I will suffer political differences. I will suffer factual inaccuracies. I will suffer misrepresentation of facts. But one thing, Ajay Alok, I will have to intervene. I will have to intervene so that you know that the Bhagwa, the Bhagwa or the saffron color in the flag for your kind and honest information represents and denotes renunciation, seeking our leaders to be indifferent to material gains and dedicate themselves to their work. Now you want to give this a RSS tinge? Go ahead. I don't think you know your facts, Ajay. Today you are being exposed completely on the program because of your political still.
I'm hearing all kinds of things on the program today. I'm quoting by what Mr. Golwalkar said.
I am quoting what S. Radhakrishnan said about the significance of the colors in the flag. Don't politicize the national flag. You are politicizing the flag.
Disciples of
You are politicizing the tricolor.
I'm not politicizing.
You are politicizing, and you should apologize for politicizing the tricolor. You are politicizing the tricolor.
Those nationalists sitting with you.
You are politicizing the tricolor, and you should not do that.
Claiming them to be nationalists, they have always politicized and they have criticized the tricolor. That's what I'm trying to say.
What I am telling you is,
and claiming themselves to be nationalists.
Okay, MR will respond.
They have criticized the tricolor all their life. And today
I don't know where you're going.
I congratulate them.
Arnab.
At least the good says have
Arnab, let me make, Arnab, let me make a quick comment.
But you must give me a hearing.
One second, please. We have two people, three people wanted to come to the debate. I'd like MR Venkatesh to come in. Shabnam hasn't spoken, neither has Saira Shah Halim. So I'm saying it aloud. Shabnam will come in after MR Venkatesh. Yes, please. MR.
Arnab, what we heard from the professor from Jadavpur University, it's very clear what is wrong with our academicia. And this symbolizes the degeneration in the academicia. Instead of telling people, instilling patriotism, instilling what is good conduct of the students, what we have is the professor telling that we are an autonomous body and we don't want to fly the national flag and that will interfere in our autonomy. I think this is utter rubbish.
University is universal in nature.
Second point.
It's not about the country. No university is about the country.
Are you a Chinese university or an Indian university?
No, professor, you said that and I have to tell it on your face. It was utter rubbish and I do not know what type of teaching you do. Second, now this is the line of argument that would be very, that would form the diplomatic circles in Pakistan. This is what Pakistan wanted, that there must be fissiparious tendencies raising their heads in the country, and this is what the enemies of the country also want, that you get divided on every single thing. Now we get even divided on the national flag. Look at it. We can get divided on caste, community, but we are getting
understand this, Professor Lahiri, that the flag does not belong to the government. The flag does not belong to the BJP. The flag belongs to the country.
Why the flag came up?
Because
we have to decide.
If you abdicate rationalism, everybody will take it.
That's
a
ridiculous argument.
No, one second.
Professor, please understand.
What was this I just heard?
Please understand the tricolor is atmosphere
in parts of the country.
Government is not attending that. Government is concerned about the flying of national flag.
Professor, I do not know what you teach, but you must understand. Just like the constitution, it symbolizes all that is India in three colors.
National flag.
Please understand, by just three colors, we symbolize what is India.
Fly the flag.
People are starving in
and you say that you do not want to fly it. This is utter nonsense.
Don't fly the flag.
I can understand a Pakistani telling this. I can understand a Chinese telling this.
G.D. Bakshi is back to the debate, please. One second.
You telling this, professor?
One second. First of all, First of all, this flag belongs to the country. It did not belong to Golwalkar. It does not belong to the BJP. It does not belong to any government. And my question is more basic. Watch this debate tonight, viewers. And this debate is so revealing. I have been saying that there are people in this country who simply dislike the idea of a strong and united India that walks and talks in one voice in the international community. That is why they can't bear to see the symbol of national pride, which was hoisted, Professor, on the 15th of August 1947, or on top of Tiger Hill after the Kargil conflict in 1999, or on Siachen, the world's highest battlefield, when we see the tricolor go up, or its presence on campuses. It cannot be questioned because of what you perceive to be shallow ideological differences. Get your facts together. As far as timing is concerned, now let me deal with Shabnam Lone argument and Ajay Alok. So I haven't heard Shabnam's yet. The point is this, I feel, this is fantastic.
Arnab, I must this come in, please.
Okay, GD Bakshi. Okay, GD. GD Bakshi and Shabnam Lone. Yeah. GD Bakshi and Shabnam
Lone. Arnab, you know, when I was told this topic...
Yes, Bakshi sir, please
when
continue.
When I was told this topic, I was wondering what we had to discuss. When I have seen the smiles on the faces of some of your protagonists today, Arnab, as an old soldier with 37 years of service, I am deeply pained and I am deeply ashamed. I realize why we soldiers are different from the civilians sitting here. In the armed forces, we die for that flag. Units, entire units have been massacred for a thing called the parcham. I often know what that is. It is a piece of silk for which hundreds of soldiers have died to see that it would keep fluttering. I'm sorry, we are not on the same page. You can smile, I cannot. And I withdraw myself from this disgusting debate and the disgusting attitude of some of your
civilians. GD Bakshi, stay on, GD Bakshi. I tell you one thing, GD Bakshi. One second. First of all, I request you. Shabnam. Shabnam ji, I want to say this to GD Bakshi first.
What is this?
GD Bakshi, I know where you're coming from. And well, I tell you this, the reason, one second, Shabnam, I'm just saying something,
this
handing it over
wrong.
To you. I would only say this today, that some people here in this studio should understand where Indian history goes back from. GD Bakshi, you speak of the pride that an Indian soldier feels. Let me tell you, all Indian citizens feel, and the professor from Jadavpur University should know that his own university was set up during the freedom movement to accommodate students who walked out of the British education system to fight for India under the tricolor. And today we have a professor from the very same university. In fact, for your kind information, please be quiet. I've listened to the rubbish that you've been speaking. You should be aware that it was Rabindranath Tagore who was one of those who helped set up the Jadavpur University for the foot soldiers of the National Freedom Movement. This Jadavpur University campus was created as an antithesis to the British education system. And I feel ashamed that 70 years later, we have a professor from the same university who says, I have my university's flag, and hence we do not need the flag of the Republic of India. Enough. Please, we don't need your symbolism. This is now not a matter of choice. And hence I'm saying tonight, don't feel, GD Bakshi, we don't feel the pain. These discussions are painful. But the reason we have them, GD Bakshi, is so that rightly the people who are trying to take this country on the wrong path are exposed.
That's right.
I say tonight, put up that flag.
Yes.
Put up flags in every central university and put it up there. Let it stand there, because when I see the flag at an airport,
that is autocracy.
Or when we walk, it is not autocracy. When I see the flag, one second. This is the level of argument that we are seeing tonight, which is going to be put out.
Put up a flag. Are you crazy?
How can you say autocracy if you put up a flag?
We must put a flag on every government building, every university.
Enough of this rubbish. I would like to get Shabnam Lone in. Yes, Sambit. Okay, 5 seconds to you, Sambit. Then Shabnam Lone has been waiting.
10 seconds to Professor Lahiri. 10 seconds to Professor Lahiri. I have to show him something.
Yeah, go on.
Professor, look at this picture. I'm just showing you a picture. The Indian jawans, the Indian jawans dying, but yet holding up the tricolor. Indian soldiers dying on the border, but holding up a tricolor.
I do respect that. The issue is different here.
We will die.
The issue you are discussing is political, not
political.
It is not political. I have full respect on that.
This is the sentiment of India.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
So we will.
But government cannot force some university, which is universal in nature, that holds the national flag.
Respect the jawans who are dying every day.
Government asks you to hold the national flag in your own country.
We hosted it on 15th August, we hosted it on 15th January.
Are you out of your mind? Government
and I also want to say something else tonight. I'd say one more thing tonight. Shabnam Lone, I'm coming to you. Viewers, I want to share something about what's been going on.
My God.
This group has been trying to paint the Patiala House louts as the patriots. The Patiala House louts
are
quiet, please. The Patiala House louts are not the patriots. Tonight on this program, every other panelist is a patriot, and I'm not going to call anyone names, but it becomes easy in the binary logic of this group to say, these people call themselves patriots. I'd say Mohandas Pai is not allowed, he's a patriot. Sunil Alagh is not allowed, he's a patriot. And General G.D. Bakshi, who feels so angry tonight, is not a Patiala House court lout. He's a patriot. Those people who try to simplify and say that the face of the patriot, and I've been seeing this coverage, they said, look at this. They put the picture of that lout at Patiala House court and say he is the contemporary patriot.
He's not.
There is an attempt to stereotype the average Indian by this group, which feels insulted, which says you put up the flag in a university, you're forcing your views on us. I'd say today that's not forcing your views. We want that reminder on those campuses as a reminder for those who advocate Azadi for Kashmir on Indian campuses, that they are studying in an Indian university, receiving an Indian education, subsidized by Indian taxpayers, and we have every right to put that up in every campus tonight.
Whatever the
same. And we have every right.
It is a reminder.
Civil society is also this. Don't think you are civil society.
All of
what
us.
Makes sure that these not civil society? Is uncivil society.
Is your last point, I'm very glad that we are having this debate because it is exposing the people, forcing them to expose themselves as being anti-Indian.
Yes, please. Shabnam Lone.
Arnab, there is no doubt that national flag is the symbol of pride of any country. But I am hearing these arguments, particularly from General G.D. Bakshi Saab, for whom I have great regard. What is it we are discussing? Nobody is discussing that the national flag can't be hoisted. It's not only about hoisting, it's about hoisting your opinion on people and the timing. I repeat the timing. Political convenience.
What timing?
Nationalism.
What timing?
Rank
what timing?
Has Smriti.
Yes, I say timing.
What timing?
No.
One second. Who's debate? Mr. Venkatesh. Mr. Venkatesh. Yes, this is the timing. This is the time. Mr. Venkatesh. Mr. Venkatesh.
Let one person.
Will you go and tell their family, Mr. Venkatesh, what is the time? Every time is the right time to hoist the national flag. Don't ever say that.
No,
don't ever politicize the national flag.
Mr. Venkatesh, I want to answer Mr. Venkatesh. I have heard this argument repeatedly, saying, Mr. Venkatesh, I have a question for you.
You will not have any argument on hoisting the national flag. Now listen to me. Now you will tell me which time is the right time.
No, no, no.
You will tell me which time is the right time.
No, no, no.
national flag? Will you go and tell it to the
government?
Will you go and tell it to the people? Will you go and tell it to the people who are dying for you and me? Burning our country has been fired minus 15 minutes. You are not speaker. You will not do this, madam. You will not do this.
One second, please. One second. She's saying something. She's having a say.
You will not say which is the right time. You will not determine the right time.
No, you will not determine.
You will not do this. You will have to tell which is the right time.
Mumbai.
You will now tell me.
Okay.
I demand. You will tell me which is the right time.
I want you are, the
I will tell you. You don't have the guts. Because you don't want to see the national flag. And that is why you want to hide our identity.
Okay, one second. Can I please request both of you to hear each other for a minute and hear me, for example. Today, Shabnam Lone. Today you say, okay, what is the great timing? Why is the tricolor being foisted? Why is there a plan to put it in central campuses? Can I tell you? I'll give my point of view on this, if I may, and then I'd like to get Saira Shah Halim onto the debate. One second. On the question of timing, I say tonight.
Smriti.
I say tonight.
I am questioning the timing.
I would say tonight.
He recently made a statement saying that this is a land which belongs to only Hindus.
Shabnam Lone, the tricolor, please, don't be superficial to the fact point of being misleading on the cause of the debate.
I do not know what rubbish are you talking.
One second, flag is not yours.
Somebody likes the national flag.
How can you divide? I'll tell you, this is the
flag is not yours.
I'd say tonight that the government and every single right thinking Indian as a counter to this revolting argument should widely foist the tricolor as an assertion. Hoisting the flag at any point is not a foisting. Never. Millions of Indians have fought to hoist, not just joist the tricolor for years. And the point that you need to understand is this, Shabnam Lone, if you have the patience to listen, I'll give you just one reason why I think the timing is perfect. I think, and I put this to the call tonight, we've listened to the rubbish that's been happening at the Jadavpur campus, JNU campus. I'd say the timing is perfect tonight because there needs to be a reminder on all these campuses that those who try to make martyrs out of terrorists and eulogize their actions, that such activity will not be entertained on Indian soil. Simple.
That is not mine.
That is the view of every right-thinking Indian.
I have always stated there is a pro-Justice League.
I'm getting
Saira Shah Halim because she has... Saira, please. Only Saira on the debate, please, right now. Can Saira speak? Saira, I'll come to you all after Saira.
Arnab. Yeah, I would like to say I've been hearing the debate of everybody. There's nothing wrong in hoisting the tricolor at central universities. The debate is not about that. Okay, right now we are talking about the timing. I just don't understand why nationalism is being thrust on under people's throat. Why are people being asked to prove their patriotism again and again?
No, you don't.
Is it to beat up a jingoistic fervor in the country?
It's silly. This is silly.
Is it to polarize communities?
One of you will debate. Okay, Mohandas Pai will respond. Saira and Mohandas Pai, please. Mohandas Pai responding. Only Mohandas Pai. Mohandas Pai.
Arnab, the Indian flag.
Saira, Mohandas Pai saying something.
Arnab, the Indian flag on the university represents all of us. It's an institution. It will be on top of the institution. That's an institution, is not the opinion opinion of anybody. It represents, please keep quiet, please keep quiet. It represents the voice of every Indian. It is paid by the taxpayer. It belongs to all of us. The usually belongs to all of us, and we must have the flag there. And anybody who says the flag should not be there, the timing is right, has to be overruled. It is not autocracy. It is the basis on which the constitution has been created, and we live by the constitution. And if we don't like it, it is perfectly okay. We do not care.
That is your person.
And which among our panelists just said that communities will get polarized by the tricolor?
No.
Who was it who said that?
I think
one of our panelists said communities will be polarized by the tricolor.
Therefore,
no, did you say that?
Belong to the flag and Muslims don't?
I mean,
the Indian flag belongs to everyone.
It's a polarized.
Everyone.
The timing
it unites.
Is wrong.
It doesn't
matter. There's nothing wrong with the timing.
That is the attitude of the government.
Shabnam Lone. Okay, Shabnam Lone. Shabnam Lone. Shabnam Lone and J.D. Bakshi. Shabnam Lone and J.D. Bakshi. Shabnam Lone and J.D. Bakshi.
One last thing.
Shabnam Lone and J.D. Bakshi.
It is not about. It is. The debate is not about. It is not about whether the flag should be hoisted or not. Flag should be hoisted.
Do it.
What I am saying is,
do it.
We host it.
Do it. Opportunism.
Why do other comes to an end? Do it.
In August, do it. On behalf of Smriti Irani.
Yes.
Okay. If it is patriotism, Arnab, why wasn't he reminded of this patriotism 6 months back?
Okay. Shabnam, if I can respond.
Yes.
Can I? No. GD Bakshi, before you come
can
in,
I
want 1 minute. I want 1 minute to respond to Shabnam Lone, then you do. Because I've been listening to this. I never thought that this debate would take this kind of a counter. There are some people who tell us, why are you desperate? Why do you want to put up the flag? To those people, I'm saying this. Why are you uncomfortable? The Indian flag makes you uncomfortable.
Yes.
Seeing the Indian flag stand there, you know, flutter in the sky makes me feel proud.
Yes.
It does not make me uncomfortable.
Yes.
I ask you in turn, why does it make you uncomfortable? I say in response to this narrow, myopic and hugely politicized lobby, I'd say to this lobby tonight, wake up, you will destroy your own country in the way that you are going. My question to you is this. My question is this. My question is this. You claim that hoisting of a flag at a central university will not necessarily instill nationalism. Now let me counter you with one simple point. Those who are already nationalists will continue to be so.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm not passing judgments on who are not, because you know then they'll say, oh, it's jingoistic to say you are being jingoistic by saying who's nationalistic and who's not. But I'm saying the flag will serve as a countervailing force against those who use Indian university campuses to advocate separatism.
Yes.
And central universities in Jammu and Kashmir will also come under the purview of this rule, which will serve an assertion of Indian identity in a state where separatist elements are only too keen to influence young minds as they do after Friday prayers every week to march out on the streets demanding Azadi. I'd say that countervailing force is required now more than ever any time before, because we need a countervailing force to the separatism that abounds in the minds of those who raise Pakistan and ISIS flags on a routine basis, egged on by their separatist leader Shabnam Lone.
Totally agree.
Right? Enough is enough. We know what's been going on.
So,
and I think the silence. No.
The argument that they raise ISIS flags and you will raise the national flag.
I am. No, please do not even. I'm saying. Crush the forces of separatists. GD Bakshi, please. GD Bakshi is on the debate. GD Bakshi, please.
Shabnam, kindly. You have raised a very, very critical point tonight. Kindly listen to me. Kindly listen to an old man. Right? I would like to tell you that it is a very sorry condition of our republic.
Yeah,
that a leftist liberal minority has created an atmosphere where every kind of patriotism is to be treated as lumpenization. What is to be celebrated is separatism on our campuses. What is to be separated is Maoism. What is to be celebrated is 76
well
innocent
said.
CRPF boys being
well
martyred
said. Well
doing
said.
Their
well
duty.
Said tonight.
What is to be separated? What is to be celebrated is every single soldier dying in Jammu and Kashmir. My problem is, I have seen those men die. You can smile.
You can smile, Mr. Professor. I will not. We will not forgive you for this, because I have seen very good men die. Men far better than you die for a piece of tattered silk. You know what you call a flag? Even for a regimental flag, people have died. And we have to discuss this. In Japan, they teach their children to be proud of their country, to be proud of Fujiyama, to be proud of the cherry blossom, to be proud of that flag. You have to debate it and you smile. God curse you.
Proud of that.
That's all that I can tell you.
The timing is important.
May you, may the benediction of hell fall on you.
We are proud of our flag.
You smile, right? I wish I could wipe that smile off your face.
We are also proud of our flag.
Let us and by the way, some people, some of these people,
can I have 10 seconds?
Yes, Ajay Alok.
I see today there's a situation where extreme nationalism is challenging constitutional patriots. This is the problem.
Ajay Alok, sorry, listen. I don't know which thesaurus you have dipped into right now. But please explain to me. Viewers, I have a question about Ajay Alok. He must hear me. The question to Ajay Alok is this. I want to understand. We say celebrate the flag. Oh, you're an extreme nationalist.
Right, go
celebrate
ahead.
Celebrate the national flag. Oh, you are so extremely nationalistic. 1 minute, I have not completed.
Can
you will speak when I finish. Ajay, wait for me. Ajay, let me counter you and then you counter me. Let me counter you and then you counter me, please, Ajay. I am saying in the United States of America, which many among you deify as the greatest democracy of the world, which it is not. It is only the most flawed democracy in the world. In the United States of America, every public education institution, in the United States of America should wear the United States flag. Now,
Let me tell you how it is a matter of convenience for them, and I will prove it through your channel. If you remember, Mr. Goswami, that universities
are hosting the national flag.
I will restrain the use of language in describing. I will restrain myself in the use of language in describing the shocking levels of your ignorance, and you claim to be an academic. I'm getting concerned for the academia at Jadavpur University. In the United States, please go and find out Section 6 of the flag code, which says that the American flag should be displayed near every single schoolhouse on school days, or near the main administration building of every public institution every day, or near every polling place on election days, so that the American citizens realize the importance of being citizens of their own country. It is only in our country that we say it is embarrassingly nationalistic to put the flag up there, and it is hitting into my tomorrow. You'll say you are curbing into my individual liberties. Tomorrow in this country, Ajay Alok, there will be people like you who will say you are curbing into my individual liberties by thrusting the national flag on me. I want to have a flag of my own. I mean, this is the most silly.
I will never say that as far as
hollow argument that I've seen in all the proves on your channel right now.
How it is a matter of convenience for extreme nationalists. I will prove it. Give me 10 seconds.
You tell me.
If you remember 13 months back,
the flag, okay?
13 months back, swearing in ceremony of
put them in the middle.
Prime Minister was there. What we see on the civilian people and what I saw right now, that's the national flag.
I say this.
Arnab, can I please reply to this?
1 second. 1 second.
Why
didn't Mr. Prime Minister never objected to that?
My God.
Why he became the part of that swearing
in ceremony? GD Bakshi is replying, and these two gentlemen in the middle, please. GD Bakshi.
Can I reply to this gentleman?
Yeah, yeah. Yes.
Arnab, he raised the issue of extreme nationalism. I would like to tell him of the boys I have seen making the extreme sacrifice. It is not a routine sacrifice.
I am also raising the issue of constitutional patriot, which you are, sir.
Can I kindly...
Sir, you are a constitutional patriot.
With your kind permission...
Right, or extreme nationalism is being right?
Extreme nationalism, sir, is needed on the battlefield to sacrifice yourself, to go beyond the call of duty, and I have seen hundreds of good men die, leave widows behind. I have seen hundreds of good men walk on plastic legs.
Are constitutional patriot. For what we require to
be. You have seen most of that. You still question the need for honoring the flag. You still question the need for honoring the flag.
Nationalist.
That is the problem. That is the problem.
And with civility.
We are not on the same page.
And with
we are different.
We are all.
You and I are different. And we will always be. I am a soldier. You are not.
We all
that are patriots, is the difference.
But we are not extreme nationalists.
What is extremely nationalistic?
That is the
enough. No, one second. Ajay Alok, a minute.
Tell me.
I'll tell you what, GD Bakshi. Can I say this? 1 minute. Sambit, before you come in. Can I say this? This group realizes their game is up. As long as they can make the Patiala House lout the face of patriotism, their game is on. The moment people like General Bakshi, Mohandas Pai or Sunil Alagh, 1 minute, don't interrupt now, don't interrupt. I have seen enough of the media in this country try to make, I have seen enough of the flawed and transgressing media in this country. Now I will have to speak over you. I want to say something to the viewers directly. Viewers, I'm saying this to you directly, please, without interruption. Viewers, you may have noticed that a section of the media is trying to use the face of that BJP MLA, OP Sharma, and the lout who calls himself a lawyer at Patiala House Court and say, see, this you call patriotism. And therefore, they want to typify and stereotype these rogues into patriots and say, hence there is no space for patriots and they have silly debates on what is patriotism. This is the silliest thing. But when GD Bakshi, Mohandas Pai, Sunil Alagh, Sambit Patra, or me, or Mr. Venkatesh come out and question it and say, listen, you define extreme patriotism as a revulsion to the tricolor, I have a problem with it. Because I would simply say today that all of us who debate on a daily basis what is potentially anti-national are not extreme patriots. All of us who argue, we don't beat. We question, we don't throw stones, we debate. Neither do we fight physically, nor do we agree with that. We are people who use simply dialectics and argument to make our point of what we believe is right for this country. And I have no hesitation in saying this. That those people who say that we have problems with the flag being put because we have our own university flag, or you are thrusting your nationalism on us, they are the misguided elements. And I put this question to the test tonight, viewers. You take your call on it. I have absolutely no problems. Viewers, I'm sharing this with you. For the last 10 days as we have debated this, you will not imagine the amount of bile, hatred and venom that is being thrown at us because our fault is only one. We ask questions. Our fault is one, we don't fall in line. Our fault is one, we love our country. We love our country and we are proud of it. And that is seen to be our greatest fault and our greatest weakness. But I'd say that is the only conviction which we have.
We call extreme nationalists.
And we are called names and called extreme nationalists.
I'm proud to be an extreme nationalist because I love my flag.
I love my country.
Because Shabnam Lone, governments come and governments go. Netas come and netas go. But there are some values which we uphold. And let me tell you that in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, I have heard that at the Kashmir University campus there was a shoot of a movie. A group of students forced filmmakers to take down the Indian flag that was hoisted on a makeshift bunker.
Oh my God.
Can such actions be tolerated in our Indian territory, in our country?
How can you forget that? What happened during swearing-in ceremony when Prime Minister Modi was there? What happened with the Indian flag then? Why do you forgot that?
10 seconds. A very important point has to be made.
Are you for it against it? 1 second. Alok, are you for it or against it?
When we have one flag, one nation.
Don't give silly reasons.
Alok, are you for it or against it?
I want to show something extremely important. Allow me to come for 10 seconds.
There should be flag everywhere. Then not only in the state university and central university. Every place there should be.
Yeah, I say tonight because the government of Pakistan's narrative about Kashmir is being given impetus on our campuses by those who are committed to a separatist cause. I want those separatists to wake up every morning and see the Indian flag flying high. I want to see those secessionists stand there and when they see the flag, know that they are too weak and we are too powerful and we will not let them carry on their disruptive activities in our soil. That we will defeat their slogans and their intentions. That is a symbol. And this flag does not represent a religion, Ajay Alok, or a political party. It represents us.
I don't say that.
It represents us. So that. Stop your politics over it, for God's sake.
Don't put me. Don't put the onus on me. I never said that. That's what you're implying.
RSS. You're implying
Mr. Arnab, can I please come in?
I never said that. I was quoting Mr. Goldwalkar.
No, I'm
going to come back with this debate.
I was quoting Mr. Goldwalkar. He said that the tricolors are not accepted.
I want to hear a young lady in Calcutta who said that this divides.
I'm taking a break and coming back with this debate. No, I'm continuing this debate. I'm taking a break. I have people. I have soldiers. I have army commanders. I have people who risk their lives call me and say, we want to speak tonight. And some are saying, we are being shocked.
Absolutely.
And I have someone who's been an army commander who says, I'm sentimental listening to this debate and to what General Bakshi is speaking. And I'll put someone on live when I come back on the other side. Back in a few minutes. Some people question the timing of why the HRD ministry now has thought about putting up the national flag in all central universities. I'd say put it up in all universities. Central, government, private, schools, colleges, you know, kindergartens. Let it be there. The flag is something to be proud about, not to be embarrassed or to be uncomfortable with. And as far as timing is concerned, I have just one thing to say. This is the best timing. And do you agree with me, viewers? I think it's the best timing because we need a reminder for those people who misuse their freedom of expression by insulting our national symbols, by calling for a breakup of India. We need our flag on our universities. For those, as a reminder to those people, watching the debate tonight closely was General Jaswal. He watched and empathized with General G.D. Bakshi. And he sent a message saying, I just want to say one thing. And General Jaswal, you're on the line with us now from Chandigarh. Go ahead, sir.
Yes.
Go ahead, sir. What would you like to say and to whom?
First of all, I am totally with General Bakshi.
General Bakshi.
All people sitting out here on the panel, they be changed who question the validity of action through our flag. Our flag represents our nationhood. We in the army believe in Naam. नमक निशान इसी देश का नमक खाते हैं एंड दे क्वेश्चन दिस वेरी नेशन इसी देश में भारत कहलाते हैं एंड भारतीय कहलाते हैं हिंदुस्तानी कहलाते हैं एंड दे क्वेश्चनिंग द वेरी वर्ड दिस वेरी फ्लैग अंड टू होम वी डाई आई टोटली एग्री विथ जीडी बख्शी दैट For a flag to be hoisted on Tiger Hill, people never thought of their families. They never thought of politics. They never thought of anything else but nation. They were there to put the flag for our nation. For heaven's sake, please realize that. Armed forces, I say, is the last bastion in this country who recognizes the actual importance of a flag. Yeah. Please don't demean it.
Yeah.
Otherwise, be ashamed. Stand below it and feel ashamed.
Ajay Alok.
And sham, what you call, hang your head in shame.
Okay. General, I thank you. Since you're not on live, I thank you for intervention. I'm not taking you on the debate. Actually, stay. I see two responses coming. Shabnam Lone and Saira seem to be uncomfortable. I wonder why. Yes, Shabnam?
Yeah.
What's your problem?
General Saab, I have got great regard for your sentiments.
You asked me something.
But the language that all of you use, kindly, with great respect,
no,
sir.
What's wrong with the language that he has used?
Kya tender mila hai patriotism ka sab logon ko, along with
what language?
How do I know you people are honest? Now, aap khud hi apni tareef kare ja rahe.
No, not at all.
Aap apni tareef khud hi kare ja rahe.
Let her complete. Let her complete.
Dusro ko.
Can I kindly answer this lady?
Represented a religion. You said that the flag would be polarizing.
Excuse me.
Who is going to vouch that all of you are great patriots?
Okay.
You are vouching for yourself, sir.
Yes.
Dusro ko to moka dijiye na kehne ka. Aap apni tareef.
Yes, we can vouch for ourselves. Yes, we can vouch for ourselves. We vouch for ourselves. GD Bakshi.
Shabnam beta.
Mr. Venkatesh after that. GD Bakshi.
Shabnam.
Mr. Venkatesh. GD Bakshi, please, before that.
Shabnam.
For my honesty.
मुझे कोई सर्टिफिकेट नहीं मिला. मुझे केवल इस सरकार की कमीशन मिली थी. मुझे एक शपथ लेनी पड़ी थी कि मुझे जहां भेजा जाए, जमीन से, समुद्र से, हवा मार्ग से मैं जाऊंगा. अगर मुझे मरना पड़े तो मैं मरूंगा. मैंने बहुत लोग मरते देखे हैं और मैं हाथ जोड़ के आपसे विनती कर रहा हूं. आप प्लीज, आप जो कुछ भी करती हैं, आप कम से कम प्लीज मेरी सुन लीजिए. प्लीज सुन लीजिए इस बुड्ढे को. मैं मुझे सर, सुन लीजिए आप मेरे. आप हमारे जवानों की कदर करिए जो मर गए हैं. ओके, आप उनको कुछ नहीं दे सकते. कोई पेंशन नहीं चाहिए. वो मर गए हैं.
आइडिया कि हम
आप समझ गए
की कदर.
आप ये कदर तो कीजिए, क्योंकि
डाइड फॉर दिस फ्लैग. मैं उनकी बात कर रहा हूँ
आपसे कि हम शहीद हूँ.
ये मेरे लिए थ्योरी नहीं है. मेरे लिए थ्योरी नहीं है. और मुझे आज बड़ा दुख हो रहा है कि हम अकेले रह गए हैं, कि हम फौजी अकेले रह गए हैं रोने के लिए.
नहीं, आप अकेले नहीं है. नो, आप अकेले नहीं है. जीडी बख्शी, लेट मी टेल यू, जीडी बख्शी, आप अकेले नहीं है. लेट मी टेल यू दैट द साइलेंट मेजोरिटी ऑफ डिसेंट पीपल इन दिस कंट्री, we don't wear patriotism on our sleeve. We are not scoundrels that we are called because we simply believe in pride for our own nation. Because we say we also wear, we look at the tricolor with the same pride that you, a soldier who was commissioned there and was prepared to give his life up for the nation. We may not be soldiers, but we are not scoundrels.
Yes.
And there is an attempt today to say that you are alone. Who says you're alone, GD Bakshi? Every single right-thinking Indian is with you tonight. As far as this argument, so you must not feel emotional about this. Because we do as well. And because there is an attempt to typify, I say tonight, GD Bakshi is the face of the Indian patriot, not the scoundrel at Patiala House Courts. GD Bakshi and soldiers like him are the face of the Indian patriot, not OP Sharma. And let all those people who want to do that stereotype because it is convenient for them, GD Bakshi, to do that. They want to get away by doing that. Let them know that you are not alone. Because people of this country have spoken up. And as far as Ajay Alok is concerned, I want to tell you, Ajay Alok, this argument of extreme nationalism. Let me tell you this. Is it extreme nationalism to ask you to stand up in the beginning of a movie screening in a theater and sing and stand for the national anthem for 52 seconds? Is it extreme nationalism? Is it extreme nationalism to ask you to stand up in attention to the national anthem played on Republic Day and Independence Day? It played on Independence Day and Republic Day. Is it extreme nationalism? What do you mean by extreme nationalism? Define it.
Stop me. Listen to me. Don't mute my voice and try to stop
me. No, it was your words, so I'm asking you, using your words.
Patriotism like you, and like I am also believe it. But what you are talking about, Mr. O.P. Sharma and set of people like that, Those people are...
They are not patriots. J.D. Bakshi is a patriot. Do not generalize. Just as Yogi Adityanath is not the face of every Hindu. Just as Yogi Adityanath is not the face of every Hindu. Just as Sadhvi Prachi is not the face of every Hindu. The Patiala House Court lout is not the face of every Indian patriot. Don't simplify this argument. Don't make it reductionist and binary. Enough people of India have spoken about what's happening now.
You are also a Hindu.
And by the... Yes, I am. So that's why I'm saying tonight, Yogi Adityanath does not represent me. I am a Hindu who also questions Shani Shingnapur. Okay? We are rational people. But it is not extreme nationalism to demand a war memorial for all our soldiers who have died defending our country since 1947. It is not extreme nationalism to invoke patriotic songs.
Patriot.
To invoke patriotic songs. To remember martyrs who laid down their lives in the defense of India on the anniversary of the Kargil conflict or the 1971 war.
No, you won't listen.
Probably. No, you need to understand this, Ajay Alok. Ajay Alok, you're not listening.
A war between ideas of extreme nationalists and constitutional...
If you think extreme nationalism is saying that you hoist the Indian flag in all universities,
extreme nationalism,
then I am an extreme nationalist. I am saying I'm an extreme nationalist
is dangerous to this country.
To hoist the flag on all universities. And for that young lady who said that it divides, look, I can understand if RSS said hoist their flag. If they said, please sing the Bhagavad Gita, that divides. How can an Indian flag divide? Are you saying the Indian flag belongs to Hindus and doesn't belong to Muslims? How does... how? Oh, 1 second.
You also carry.
The lady.
No, no, no.
Please
how
carry.
Can the Indian
okay,
flag
it's their right to carry.
How does the
their
Indian
right
flag
to carry.
Divide? Once. I want to know from her.
No, no, the point that emerges is this. How can taking pride in being an Indian without thrusting that pride down the throats of others qualify as extreme nationalism?
The debate here is not about wanting to hoist the national flag here, sir.
The debate is about...
The debate is about the necessity. That is the debate.
The debate is that whoever is anti-government is anti-national.
What is the anti-government part of it?
What is anti-government in hoisting the flag?
Oh, come on.
She doesn't know which debate she's on.
Absolutely not.
I'm sorry, you don't know which debate you're on. You have no idea what we are debating then, young lady. Please stop. The debate is on the Indian...
Okay, before we close now.
That's the debate.
Before we close now, I have Smriti Rani on the phone line now. 1 second. Once she hasn't spoken since this happened. 1 minute. 1 minute. Smriti Rani is on. She's been watching the debate. She'd like to say something. Smriti. Smriti Rani, please. The debate has started on this. You called in. You wanted to say something.
I'm calling tonight not as a minister. I'm calling tonight as a citizen who sees tears in the eyes of men like G.D. Bakshi. This is a message only for him.
J.D. Bakshi.
There are political battles, explanations, speeches and debates which will ensue in the forthcoming session of Parliament. But as an Indian citizen tonight, I want to tell men like G.D. Bakshi, it is the greatest tragedy of my nation today that I see tears in the eyes of a brave soldier like you, sir. Let me say this as every Indian watching you tonight would say. Men like you have bled for our country. Men like you have never asked us for anything in return. And tonight, as you weep on Newshour, I will only say this as an Indian citizen. We are grateful for your sacrifices. We are grateful for your service. And under that flag, every day, knowingly, unknowingly, know this, we shall be grateful forever.
Thank you, Smriti Rani. Smriti Rani, who called in tonight, G.D. Bakshi, I will wrap up by saying this. Take a call tonight. Every Indian is with you.
Absolutely.
Every Indian is
Absolutely.
With you. And in your thoughts, you have expressed our own feelings. We are absolutely against the lumpens. But we are not extreme nationalists. We are just proud Indians. I thank you all for joining me on debate number one on the Newshour tonight. Thank you.